Morning, Department of Graduate and Technical Education, Highway Geometry Design of Horizontal Alignment Elements, Module 2, Session 8, Highway Engineering of 5th Semester, Civil Engineering. Subject code is 18CB56. Today, let us discuss about the vertical alignment. The vertical alignment is the elevation or the profile of center line of the road. The vertical alignment consists of grade and vertical curve as it influences the speed, acceleration, sight distance and comfort in vehicle movement on the highway. Here in the figure you can see that there is a vertical curve. Here you are going to face a problem with respect to the sight distance, with respect to the acceleration and also with respect to the speed. Here also you can see that in this figure, right, there is a curve as well as a vertical gradient. So let's see the different types of gradient and how the gradients are represented. It is a rate of rise or fall along the length of the road with respect to the horizontal. Either it is a rise or it is a fall. It is expressed as ratio of 1 in x, that is 1 vertical unit to x horizontal unit. Sometimes the gradient is also expressed as percentage, that is n percentage, n in 100. Ascending gradients are usually represented by positive sign, it is represented by n, and descending gradients are represented by negative. So here you can see an ascending gradient. The ascending gradient curve, we call it as a summit curve, and the descending gradient, we call it as a valley curve. Types of gradient. There are four types of gradient: ruling gradient, limiting gradient, exceptional gradient, and minimum gradient. Ruling gradient, usually it is the design gradient. What the designer or a civil engineer or a highway engineer will go into aim whenever he is designing a curve. It is a maximum gradient within which the designer attempts to design the vertical profile of the road. It depends upon type of terrain, length of grade, speed, pulling power of the vehicle, presence of horizontal curve and mixed traffic. Let's see what is the meaning of limiting gradient. Usually they are steeper than the ruling gradient. In hilly areas or in hilly roads, it may be frequently necessary to exceed the ruling gradient and to adopt limiting gradient. It depends on topography and cost of construction in road. So wherever it is not possible to provide the ruling gradient, need to provide a limiting gradient. Exceptional gradient. Exceptional gradients are very steeper gradients given at unavoidable situations. Wherever it is not possible to provide both the ruling and the limiting gradient, exceptional gradients are provided. And also, these exceptional gradients are for a very short stretch of a road, about say 100 meters on a highway. Critical length of the grade. The maximum length of ascending gradient which a loaded truck can operate without undue reduction in the speed is called as critical length of the grade. So whenever the truck, that too heavily loaded truck, is climbing the vertical curve, it should not reduce its speed. So that length is called as the critical length of the grade. A speed of 25 km/h is a reasonable value. The value depends upon the size, power, load and also the initial speed. Minimum gradient. It is important only at locations where surface drainage is important. That means you cannot provide a zero gradient. You need to provide some gradient because of drainage consideration. So whatever the water which falls on the ground, it has to be effectively disposed of. So, for that, you need to have what is known as a minimum gradient. Camber will take care of the lateral drainage, but the longitudinal drainage along the side drains require some slow for smooth flow of water. Therefore, minimum gradient is provided for drainage purpose, and it depends upon the rainfall, type of soil, what type of soil, or how much is the seepage, how much is the absorbing power, and also the other site conditions. A minimum of 1 in 500 may be sufficient for concrete drain and 1 in 200 for an open soil drain. So for every 1 meter, for a 500 meter longitudinal distance in case of a CC drain. So the desired value of gradient as per IRC. So it depends upon the terrain, whether it is a plain terrain, rolling terrain, etc. Plain terrain, rolling gradient 3.3%, limiting gradient 5%, exceptional gradient is 6.7%, mountainous terrain 5%, 1 in 20, 6% and 7%. Steep terrain up to 3000 meter, MSL mean sea level 5%, 1 in 20, 6% and 7%. Steep terrain more than 3000 meter, 6%, 7% and 8%. So you need to remember some of these values, the value of both the rolling gradient as well as the limiting gradient. Let's see the summit curve and the problems on summit curve. So the length of the summit curve, so in the previous slides I have shown the figure of a summit curve as well as a valley curve. So first one, case one, when length is greater than stopping side distance, the length of the summit curve is greater than stopping side distance is given by the formula L equals NS square divided by square root of 2H capital H plus square root of 2 into small h, or L equals NS square divided by 4.4. Second case, L is less than stopping side distance, L equals 2S minus square root of capital H plus square root of 2h small h divided by n is equal to L equals 2s minus 4.4 by n. Here you can note on that h, capital H and h are the height of the driver's eye level above the ground level, and also small h is the height of the object above the ground level. So it is 1.5 meter and 1.2 meter and 0.15 meter. L is greater than OSD. So in the previous case we consider stopping side distance, here we considering overtaking side distance. L equals NS square divided by 8H, or L equals H, substituting the value of H as 1.2 meter. So NS square divided by 9.6, that is the length of the summit curve. Similarly, when the length is less than OSD, L equals 2S minus 8H minus N, or in other words, L equals 2S minus 9.6 by N. So these are the formulas to find out the length of the summit curve in case of a overtaking site. So notations, coming to the notations, what is N, S, etc. S is the site distance, that is SSD or OSD. N is the deviation angle, algebraic difference. That is the algebraic difference of the two grades. One may be an ascending gradient and another may be a descending gradient. H, height of the driver's eye above the carriage bay, that is 1.2 meter. And small h, height of the object above the carriage bay of the roadway, which is the 0.15 meter. Let's see how to calculate the valley curve, length of the valley curve. Length of the valley curve for comfort conditions, we consider comfort condition, which is equal to L equals 2 into N V divided by 3.6 whole to the power of cube, entire thing divided by C, and the entire thing is square root, that is whole to the power of, or L equals, you can just remember this formula, 0.38 NV cube whole to the power of half, or square root of in B cube, where N is the deviation angle, that is the algebraic difference between the two grids. C is the rate of change of centrifugal accelerations, which will be taken as 0.6 meter per second cube, and B is the speed of the vehicle in km/ph. Length of the valley curve for the headlight side distance, L is greater than stopping side distance. L equals N square divided by 2H1 plus 2S tan alpha, or in other words, L equals N square divided by 1.5 plus 0.035S. Case 2, L is less than SSB. L is equals 2S minus 2H1 plus 2S tan alpha divided by N, or L equals 2S minus 1.5 plus 0.035S divided by N. So here H1 is height of the headlight above the carriageway. Alpha is inclination of the focus portion of the beam of light with respect to the beam angle. N is the deviation angle, that is the algebraic difference of two grids. One may be positive or one may be negative, or both may be positive and both may be negative, etc. S, headlight side distance is equal to stopping side distance. Let's see one or two problems based on our discussion. A vertical summit curve is formed at an intersection of two gradient, plus 3% and minus 5%. Design the length of summit curve to provide a stopping side distance for a design speed of 80 km/h. Assume all other data as per IRC. Solution. So the speed is given. Speed is 80 km/h. Gradient N1 plus 3% and N2 minus 5%. So the first one, what we need to determine? Determination of stopping side distance, that is SSD. As there is an ascending gradient on one side, that is the summit, and the descending gradient, that is the valley curve, on the other side, it is assumed that the effect of gradient on the stopping side distance gets compensated or ignored. So we don't consider this gradient in case of a stopping side distance. So neglecting that, substitute the formula of stopping side distance, 0.278 Vt plus V square divided by 254 F. Here assume T as 2.5 second, friction, coefficient of friction 0.35, and design speed of 80. So substituting that value, we are getting stopping side distance as 128 meters. Determination of length of summit curve. So deviation angle N is given by N 0.03, one is plus, another one is minus. So algebraic difference 0.03 minus of minus 0.05. So that becomes plus 0.08. Assume L is greater than SSD. Substitute the formula, L equals N square divided by 4. Just check whether the condition satisfies or not. So L equals N square divided by 4.4. So N is, just now we have calculated algebraic difference. One is ascending and another one is descending. So it is 0.08 into S square. Just now we have calculated stopping side distance, 128 square divided by 4.4. So it is 298 meters. This value of the summit curve, L, is greater than SSD. So just now what was the assumption? L is greater than SSD. So here the L is 128 meter. So the SSD is 128 meter, L is, so just now we calculated 298 meter. So our assumption is correct, that is 298 is greater than 128 meter. So hence this same length may be accepted for the design. So the length of the summit curve is 298 meter. Next, check the minimum specified length as per the IRC guideline. So it's table. You refer the Khanna and Justo book, there they have given the table, right? Table 4.17 for the design speed of 80 km/h. So the minimum speed length for a summit curve of 50 meter, and therefore the design length of summit curve is 298 meter. So there only 50 meter is required, but here we are getting 298 meter. So whatever the design length we got it for the summit curve, that holds. That is 298 meter. Second example, a vertical summit curve is to be designed when two grades +1/50 and -1/80 meet an high way. The SSD and OSD required are 180 and 640 meter respectively. But due to the site condition, the length of the vertical curve has to be restricted to a maximum value of 500 meters only. If possible, calculate the length of summit curve needed to fulfill the requirements of stopping site distance, OSD, overtaking site distance, or at least intermediate site distance. Solution. So let's see what are the data given. So desired values of SSD are 180 meter and 640 meter. Maximum length of summit curve is here, they have given it as 500 meter, and gradients are 1 + 1/50 and -1/80. So let's see, calculate the deviation angle. N equals algebraic difference +1/50 minus of -1/80 negative, that is the valley curve. So we are getting 13/400. Requirements of the stopping site distance, assume as usual, first we assume and calculate it. If it satisfies the condition, then whatever the value we got it, that can be used. Okay. So assume L is greater than SSD of 180 meter. Use the formula L equals N square divided by 4.4. So N, just now we got it, 13/400. Substitute that value into S square, 180 square divided by 4.4. So we got the answer 240 meter. As the length is greater than SSD, the assumption is correct. So whatever the value we got it, it is more than the SSD. So our assumption is correct. The length of the summit curve required is 240 meter, which is less than the prescribed maximum limit of 500 meter. In the problem, they have given it as 500 meter maximum. So it is less than that. So hence it is accepted. Second one, requirements of overtaking site distance. As the length L of the summit curve is to be restricted to 100 meter, which is less than the required OSD of 640 meter. So all these two values are given in the problem itself. So assume, as usual, assume L is less than OSD of 640 meter. Use the formula L equals 2S minus 9.6. divided by N, which is the deviation angle. 2 into 640 minus 9.6 divided by 13/400. We got it 984.6 meter. As the length of the summit curve obtained is higher than the OSD of 640 meter, our assumption is wrong, or our assumption is not correct. Also, in this problem, it is specified that the length of the summit curve is not restricted to a value less than 500 meter. Therefore, it is not possible to provide a OSD of 640 meter at that summit curve, which is limited to 500 meter. Therefore, attempt may be made to design the summit curve to provide an intermediate site distance, which is equal to 180 twice the SSD, right? So 180 into 2, that is 360 meters. Assume L is greater than SD of 360 meter. Use the formula L equals N square divided by 9.6. So 13/400 into 360 square. So use that formula, substitute the values. We got 439 meter. As this value is greater than the assumed SD, that is 439 is greater than 360 meter, hence our assumption is. As the length of the summit curve is 439 meter, which is also less than the maximum available length of 500 meter. So provide the design length of summit curve L as 439 meter, which fulfills both the conditions of ISD and OSD. Let's discuss about the grade compensation. At the horizontal curve, due to the turning angle alpha of the vehicle, the curve resistance developed, which is equal to T into 1 minus cos alpha. When there is an horizontal curve, in addition to the gradient, there will be an increase in resistance to fraction due to both gradient and curve. It is necessary that in such a cases, the total resistance due to grade and the curve should not exceed the resistance due to maximum value of gradient specified. Maximum value generally is taken as the ruling gradient. The grade compensations can be defined as the reduction in gradient at a horizontal curve because of additional tractive force required due to curve resistance, that is T minus T into cos alpha, which is intended to offset the extra tractive force involved at the curve. So the IRC has given the following specification for grade compensation. Grade compensation is not required for the grades flatter than 4% because the loss of tractive force itself is negligible. Grade compensation is 30 plus r by r percent, where r is the radius of the horizontal curve in meters. The maximum grade compensation is limited to 75 divided by r percent. So here I have given the figures of this vertical curve. Okay, so here you can see how in a hilly area how the vertical curves are formed. Let's discuss some of the multiple choice questions based on our discussions. The vertical alignment of the highway includes side distance and traffic intersection, widening of the pavement, design of valley curves and gradients, highway lighting. So the answer is design of valley curves and gradient. Answer is C. The rolling gradient required for a plane or a rolling terrain is 1 in 15, 1 in 20, 1 in 30, 1 in 40. So the answer is 1 in 30. C. The maximum grade compensation for a curve of radius 75 meter is, so 1%, 1.4%, 1.5% and 1.6%. So it is, formula is 75 by r. So 75 by 75, that is 1%. So the answer is A. The vertical alignment does not influence side distance, vehicle operation cost, accident, vehicle speed. So the answer is accident C. So definitely it will influence side distance, VOC, vehicle operation cost and also the vehicle speed, but it does not affect or influence the accident. The angle which is measured at change of direction of two gradient is called as standard angle, subtended angle, deviation angle, setback. The answer is C, that is deviation angle. The length of the summit curve is based on dash, comfort condition, side distance, convexity, deviation angle. The answer is B, that is side distance. The value of A in the equation y equals a square used in the summit curve is n by 2l, n by 3l, n by 4l, n by 5l. The answer is A, n by 2l. If the length of the summit curve having an SSD of 150 meter and a deviation angle of 1 in 30 is, so use the formula L equals N square divided by 4.4. So use the value of N, 1 in 150, S square, 150 square divided by 4.4 into 30, we are getting 170 meters. So answer is 50 meter, 100 meter, 150 meter and 170 meter. So the answer is B, 170 meter. Use the formula N square divided by 4.4 and substitute the values. If the deviation angle of the curve is 1 in 200 and the design speed is 80 kmph, then calculate the total length of the valley curve for the comfort condition. 18.22, 18.52, 19.22, 19.52, meters. So answer is C, 19.22 meters. Just use the formula, comfort condition, 0.38 into nv cube whole to the power of half or square root of nv cube. Substitute the values. So you will get it 19.22 meters. The equation for length is less than OSD for a summit curve is given by ns by 8h, ns square by 8h, ns square by 10h, ns square by 12h. So the answer is, as per the equation, right, it is ns square by 8h. Thank you.